everybody. Thank you so much. My name is Dr. Trevor Davis, and I'm the Assistant Professor of Clarinet Saxophone and the Director of Jazz Activities over at Louisiana Tech University. I want to say a big thank you to Dr. Eric Suderveld for inviting us over here tonight in our efforts to create more jazz opportunities and more jazz things happening in northern Louisiana, which I think is a great thing. So I hope that this continues to be an annual event, and we hope to do some more cross-collaborating and all those great things that need to happen. So the first tune you heard is not on your program. I got a call yesterday, and Eric said, would you like to know the tune? I said, yes, but I don't know what it is yet. And so today, during our rehearsal, we added that one. That was a tune called The Red Door by Barry saxophone player Jerry Mulligan and the tenor saxophone player Zoot Sims. The Red Door, that featured Madison Pertini on tenor saxophone and James Roberts over there on piano. So the best thing is the collaboration and just the music of jazz, but a really special thing is that you all get the treat of hearing the special guest that that Dr. Suderveld organized for us. And so when he invited, if Tech wanted to play here, I said, absolutely. He said, have a couple charts, and this guy's gonna play on you. I said, okay, great. I've got two charts we could do with him. So it's my pleasure. I just met this guy about an hour ago, and you're in for very special treats. Please help me welcome to the stage a little Los Angeles-based saxophonist, multiple woman player, Bill Todd. So Bill's going to solo on a couple tunes with us, this one and also our last tune, and then he'll also join the ULM's jazz ensemble, and he'll tear it up on that one too. So we're going to continue on with a Mike Tamaro tune called Another Story. Thank you. James Roberts again on piano over there for us. Okay, so don't worry. There is more Bill Todd coming. There should be 30,000 more people in here for that. So we'll work on that for next year. Don't worry. Okay, what are you doing up here? Okay. Do you wanna play a tune? Okay. We're gonna continue on. This is a ballad. We're gonna feature our trumpet player, Dakova Bex. This is a Benny Carter tune. Benny Carter was a great saxophonist and writer. And this is arranged by Brent Walrap. And Eric Serveld and I both know Brent Walrap. I played in his jazz band at Indiana University. And Eric studied some composition and arranging with Brent Walrap. And so, and I find with Brent's writing, it's always very clean and very clear. And I think he does a really great job with this beautiful tune. So I hope you enjoy Wonderland. Thank you. This is a fun one, and the students have no fun doing this either. Just one change in the solo order. It will be Dalton Cade on Barry sax, and then Tyler Poe on alto sax, and then Dakova on trumpet, and then Bill Todd will do it again. So, let's welcome back to the stage Bill Todd. Bill's out here, I know, and he's gonna have to wait a little while before he finally gets to play, but when he does, oh boy. So, thanks again for inviting us here, Eric. I really appreciate it, looking forward to hearing your group next. So it'll be a really, really quick changeover, so don't bother going anywhere, and I hope to meet all of you after this and say hello, and looking forward to hearing the Elms Jazz Band. So this is Charles Mingus's Moanin'.
Oh, Thank you.
want to say a quick thank you to Dr. Davis for bringing the Louisiana Tech Jazz Ensemble over here. You all sounded beautiful tonight. Fabulous job. Really, really a pleasure to hear you all this evening. It wouldn't have been possible to put this concert on without the help of Louisiana Tech being here, and without the help of a couple of other people who I would really like to thank at the beginning of our concert tonight. First, I want to thank Dr. James Bolden for helping fund our clinician this evening, Bill Todd, and then also Ecute Press. Both of those, both Dr. Bolden and Ecute Press, had a hand in helping fund bringing our Los Angeles-based saxophonist out here. The other person who was of great assistance was Dr. Daryl Long, assisting with the travel. I don't know if you know or not, but it's not cheap to fly right now. And so we had to get a couple of different funding sources together to make sure we could have our guest artist here tonight and clinic our students this evening. He did a couple of lessons today and then spoke with the band. And hopefully, as you hear tonight, we bring a little bit of a different energy. Our guest tonight, Bill Todd, has been a friend of mine. I was just thinking about this actually while I was sitting out there for 11 years now. I've known him for 11 years, and we shared many, many, many hotel rooms together because we were on the road together with a Broadway tour of Young Frankenstein, and then again with the Broadway tour Elf, and then again when we performed Elf at Madison Square Garden. So I've known him for a long time. He was also a groomsman at my wedding. So he's been a very dear friend for a long time, and it's very exciting for me to have the pleasure to introduce to you tonight, Bill Todd. Is a composition by the great John Burke's Dizzy Gillespie. This is Night in Tunisia, and it will feature in the role of Dizzy Gillespie, our own Solomon Abang, and then in the role of Charlie Parker, Bill Todd. So we hope you enjoy A Night in Tunisia. Go on ahead, Ethan. Thank you.
addition to our program as well, because I woke up this morning and decided there should be. So the band, we spent our sound check today rehearsing another chart for you all tonight. But up next, we're going to feature a tune written by the great Kenny Dorham, who was a trumpeter, famous in the bebop era. And we're going to invite Bill Todd back to stage to join us. This is Kenny Dorham's Una Mas. Thank you. sprung this chart on the jazz ensemble this morning, though, if you pay attention to our Instagram, which I'm sure all of you do, you check it every day religiously because you really know how important Instagram is. We were fortunate to be joined by Bill virtually on this chart. So the band recorded this tune, and then Bill and I actually played a little duet on it. And tonight, I thought it would be better that Bill take the spotlight since he's a much better musician and he's more attractive. So up next. Also, appropriately, this tune was originally recorded by Bob Kernow and his LA-based big band, which features a who's who of musicians from the Los Angeles area. You probably won't know any of their names, but you have absolutely heard most of them if you've ever seen... if you've ever seen a movie. So a lot of the people in this big band are featured on films, film soundtracks and things like that. So clearly a very good big band. And since they're LA-based and our saxophonist tonight is LA-based, I thought it would be appropriate to pull out the great Pat Metheny, his composition, Always and Forever.
Thank you.
6:10 a.m. So I'm just gonna keep him up all night. Genuinely, thanks for coming out, Billy. The final composition we have for you is from the Clayton Hamilton Band, but written by the pianist Horace Silver, who is a very, very important pianist during the hard bop era. And this is his tune called "The Jody Grind," off of an album of the same name. So I want to thank you all for coming out and spending a little bit of your evening with us. This is our final concert for the semester. And the last thing I want to say is a very serious, deep thank you from myself and from the band to Chris Moravec, our tenor player, who is, when did you start playing with the band?
8 years.
8 years. So he's been playing with this band for 8 years, and he is off. He and his family are off to North Carolina. This month, right? Or middle of next month. So we want to say thank you to Chris for spending all this time with us, sharing his wisdom, sharing his talent, and sharing his experience. And we will certainly miss you, but we wish you well, Chris. So thank you for everything you have done. You know, it's always nice to have somebody with experience to share an ensemble. It's my second year as the director. When I came in, Chris was a huge help in sort of helping me transition into that role. And, you know, it made it much, I think, much smoother than it otherwise may have been. So, last tune of the night, and then you all have to go home. You can't stay here. This is the Jody Grind.